Well played here from low on the forehand side. Simone Gauzy spinning it up and then blocking right back to the opposite corner. Solid start for the French showman. This is something you'll see a lot of from Xu Xin, stepping around that backhand corner to play the forehand. Gauzy trying to play the short side. Not easy to do with the heavy topspin coming in, but he'll have to go for it throughout. Find different answers. Steady spin, though, from inside the table. Xu Xin with the backhand. It's getting more and more steady in recent times.
3-1.
A gift for Xu Xin on the receive. Again, pressure when you're serving to someone who's so good inside the table as Xu Xin is. And stepping back just a little bit behind the table to have a little more time and control. Gauzy keeping it to the backhand though. It's one forehand in there, Xu Xin. Just missed timing that last one. Nice change of pace from Simone Gauzy. And the gift has been re-gifted. I was gonna say earlier when Simone Gauzy did it that Xu Xin, as I mentioned yesterday, has been known to serve into the net more than any of his, well, Chinese national team teammates in terms of the big four. Doesn't stop him from dominating the game though. At least against foreigners, but Simone Gauzy knows that he has a chance because on the biggest stage they've played yet, and the biggest stage on any non-Olympic year, Simone Gauzy took the victory, and it was a similar situation. Xu Xin, the only Chinese player left on his half of the draw. Right down the line, well played from Gauzy. Heavy spin coming in, but a closed racket and well balanced. Stays on top of this spinny shot. Fearless play from Simone Gauzy. Patrick Sheila in the corner, celebrating that shot. Three serving five. There's a rocket shot here. Xu Xin turns up the heat a little bit on the aggressive. Just top edge of the racket as that one really kicks with the spin. Blitzes the table and has to make another one, rushing in, punches the ball back two times in a row, and still Xu Xin returns with a hooking forehand. Spectacular play after backing off the table. Moves right back in to take advantage. One foot in the air for that shot. Outstanding play from the French showman to maintain his lead and extend it back to two. From the soft one, gets right back into the fast pace of play on top of the bounce as Xu Xin fans watch nervously from the front. Qin Zhijian in the corner, again has been working with the men here. You saw him last match for Fan Zhendong. 3-point lead for Simone Gauzy. Wraps around this one, a bit of side spin on it to bend as well. Very cautious as he comes in with the open face of the racket. Looks quite patient before the point of contact. Takes incredible control and confidence to be able to do that. There tends to be a sense of panic for many players against the top Chinese players in the world, or more less specifically, the top player in the world by world ranking. Xu Xin currently world number one. Again, a side spin chop after a rally like this. I don't even remember all the side spins he put on it, but an inside out forehand, Xu Xin on the chase. There's the touch shot, first of many. There's the inside out forehand. Even wider, Simone Gauzy just pulling that like he was starting a lawnmower, and then the kill shot to drive it through one more time. Look how low this is. This is a specialty shot. Very close to the top, but just hitting the side as Simone Gauzy tries to go around the net. Heavy spin from the side spin on the brushing backhand to the follow-up attack, Simone Gauzy. Again, constantly changing the pace. And on that last winning shot, it wasn't the speed that did it, it was the spin, 10 serving five. Deep to the backhand, Shuxin handles well on the receive, saving game point. Six serving 10. Not a bad follow-up either, a parallel shot to the deep forehand corner. And fast backhand does it from just at the baseline of the table. Simone Gauzy takes game number one. Parallel backhand to control, Gauzy picking his placement very specifically, quite wisely so far. Very difficult to play. Gauzy does something quite clever there to spin it to the backhand one more time when he had the whole table open. He avoids the forehand after that jumping backhand shot, but still Shuxin able to cause some trouble as he turns to play the forehand from the backhand side. That ball was near his left knee and still lunging forward, able to take the shot, make the shot, and win the point. That one's just too tough to handle. Using that penhold grip very well with the dangling racket to play inside the table and steal the opening attack. One of the many things that the penhold grip can be advantageous for. Over the table play. A lot of reasons for that flexibility in the wrist. Also, you're not fighting gravity. Racket's hanging down naturally. Subtle differences as rackets aren't maybe as heavy as bats in other sports. But if you've never played with a professional racket, especially the Chinese national team equipment, you'd be surprised how heavy they are. Well played right down the middle. I'm curious what the expression there was from Simone Gauzy. Every once in a while you'll see someone just upset at themselves, but that almost looked to be directed at the assistant umpire. Too strong, Shuxin into the towel break. I don't know if something was said, or maybe it was just him disappointed with the decision he had made. Simone Gauzy, traditional backhand there. With the ball played out to the forehand, Shuxin patient on that backhand corner. This is one thing that in 2019 helped him a lot, that patience and confidence in the backhand. A quality shot catches the edge, a bit of fortune for the French showman. So a 1-point game now, Cloud Walker with his second serve. Trying for a heavy side spin on a brushing backhand after the touch shot before and a little break off the net. Shuxin remains calm, stays cool, takes the point. Heavy spin from Simone Gauzy. Almost straight side spin here, causing a bit of confusion as it catches the top edge of Shuxin's racket on the counter. The wrist, even for that shot, for the touch shot. Look how much bend there is on that ball. I talked about the side spin before the match. And it's tough to say that anything positive there's someone who has more of than Shuxin, but in terms of the side spin, Simone Gauzy has demonstrated that already throughout the match. As creative as Shuxin is, still playing slightly safer, more standard than Simone Gauzy with his dangerous attempts, his touch shots, slowing the ball way down. Chops and everything else he's brought so far. Lobs from the fishing to the lobs. And the counter backhand finds the net. Always tough to counter from that far behind the table, but he was able to do it against Hugo Calderano quite consistently. His backhand has definitely developed in recent years, Simon Gauzy. Sky lob. Now, normally, we'll see a player twiddle the racket. I imagine because of the penhold grip, the rubber's cut differently on one side of his racket. Could be that, or it could be that he just wanted to keep the tacky rubber out to play spinny shots in case Simon Gauzy counters. I'm sure some fans on social media will send me videos of Shushin twiddling the racket, if they can find it. In the middle of a rally against lobs, for example, as we see most of the shake hands players do for the Chinese national team. So the first one a bit slower and spinnier, second one about 80% from Simon Gauzy. It's right to the middle, something that Shushin doesn't just clobber for the next ball. And he's a step behind the table, no need to try to outspeed him unless you're hitting it out of reach. Fast turn to the corner, Shushin taking the attack and extending his lead to 3 points. Just missing the contact from behind the table. Gauzy, a little bit more passive. Yeah, a little bit more responsive play here, just tries to fish it up. But the ball dips so much, it appears to catch the bottom edge of the racket. Chop block from Gauzy, mostly side spin, not a lot of under on it. Shushin overlifts. So 3 points in the lead now, Shushin. Cracking backhand and then the follow-up forehand. It's a tough shot. We've seen Simon Gauzy make it on a few occasions before. But the parallel here coming just inside the ball. Beautiful backhand. Shushin covering the middle, and then from under the table. That shot comes down, it's trouble. And backhand 11, just long, the favor returned, an 11 to 6. Shushin with the serve. Well placed deep to the corner here, that drive of Shushin. Always a little bit different in terms of the arc of the ball. And down low, you'll have a chance to see. Ball comes just below the racket as it dips out. There it is, this time it comes down. The side swiping forehand on the move. Gauzy quite creative, quite inventive here. Side swipe across the chest to make the ball bend out of reach.
One, two.
Again, Simon Gauzy hitting heavy topspin on the first two, a little bit safer. See the arc on this ball, making sure he gets the ball into play, and as soon as it's countered back from Shushin, doesn't have quite the luxury of time. And he lobs him down. Few do. Only from time to time have I seen it. Simon Gauzy very comfortable behind the table in general. He was very persistent on keeping away from that wide forehand of Shushin early in the rally. Soft shots. No lip read needed. The facial expression, I think, said it all. She was seen a bit surprised. Usually comfortable and in control against the high balls. People don't lob me down. I lob people down. As someone who's so comfortable behind the table like Xu Xin, and with the big forehand that he has, he's one of the taller members of the Chinese national team. A bit surprising for him to not come out victorious from that point. Quality backhand after the forehand flick, and Xu Xin stepping into the lead here. There's that side spin, the brushing, bending backhand of Gozi covering the middle well. The strawberry attempted, but it finds the net. Quite a low serve. It looked like he wasn't quite able to get the top spin he's used to on that strawberry. Huh? From that angle, could see a little bit of it.
No!
And a tight shot. And the soft play, big point here for Gozi to stay even. At least tie it back up. Oh, what a shot. Xu Xin moves quickly to that wide forehand. Gozi finally decides to go out to the wide forehand. Looked like quite a good shot, but Xu Xin leaps, just pounces on it. One from the backhand, and with his head down and his racket up, counters back for the win. And that brushing, bending backhand once again. This shot, Simone Gozi's consistency right now is crazy impressive. The difficulty of this shot, nice after motion. There's the bend. You can see how much side spin is on as it hooks into the body of Xu Xin. That's right. Keep it up. Bend it into that backhand. Many talk about Waldner when you think about competition against the Chinese or the competition that the Chinese has had over the last few decades. As much power as you can get from behind the table, full commitment on the forehand. Gozi from the backhand corner with authority is able to take this point. How far back he is, as loose as can be, that wrist completely cocked back. He had everything snapping on that shot. On top of the bounce once again, two shots in a row, quick to the forehand and followed up to the backhand side. Gozi with a 2-point lead. I was watching live when they played the World Championships match, and Simone Gozi was outstanding, but the way he's playing right now, for me, even better. Heavy spin from the backhand as well. A 3-point lead, 2 points away, but still a long way to go when you're playing against Xu Xin. The reason I brought up Waldner was basically because of his creativity, giving the Chinese top players something they weren't used to dealing with. Variety of side spins, chop blocks, and everything else.
Seven, nine.
Not quite getting the grip he wanted on that second one. But after changing it up, watch how soft this shot is here. Soft, shallow flick. It goes for the spinny forehand. It is quite humid in here. Ah, the chop block well handled, well read. Xu Xin plays it back brilliantly, and Gozi spins it and earns himself 3 game points. Good good attempt. Hangs in there for the first fast shot from near the table, but the backhand just behind comes back long as Xu Xin saves game point. That heavy side spin, how much the ball comes up off the racket. So the heavy spin comes in. Gozi says, why not snap forward with the closed racket? It's tricky with Xu Xin. Again, the ball constantly curving and bending. Different amounts of topspin, different combinations of spin on his shots. Still two game points left for Simon Gozi. Down the middle of the table does it, 11-8. Versus Xu Xin, where Xu Xin is the only Chinese player on his half of the bracket. Aggressive right on top of the third ball opportunity. First point to Simon Gozi. So pendulum serve takes its bend right near the baseline of the table. Keeps Xu Xin opening up from deep. No towel break needed, just a shoulder for that behind the ear sweat. That'll probably be the last time I ever say that. And sticking to the game plan here on top of the bounce, trying to end the rally quickly where possible. Gozi with a lot of spin coming in. Xu Xin makes for a difficult third ball, ties it up. Ah, and a taste of his own medicine coming across the ball. An abbreviated stroke from Xu Xin. Watch one more time how deep this is into the body. Just a step outside the table to play the forehand from the backhand side. Quick reaction, too.
One, three.
So solid start here from the world number one. The bottle challenge serve comes back. It's an interesting position to be in, but I see clear focus, clear tactics from Simon Gozi. Keep it to the backhand. Once the rally's open, go for the big shots. Wide to the forehand where possible when there's an opening.
Four, two.
Early attacks deep to the backhand when he can. But the only time we really see him go to the forehand is an inside-out shot, a parallel shot. If he thinks it's going to be untouchable, much like you would against a lobber. That's how it is in the rallies here. If he can get Xu Xin to step around, still he's using the length of the table, keeping it to the backhand, as Xu Xin's used to chasing down the opposite corner next. Now from this camera angle, it looked like Xu Xin had a clearer sense that that ball was not going to hit the table. Simon Gozi from under will have a nice chance to see the spin in a moment. Chop from under the table. Watch this one. If that comes down, it's got side and under spin on it. Very unusual ball to play. I don't know if I've ever seen another professional play that shot with the consistency Simon Gozi has. Oh, goes out to the forehand for the bending shot. And even with the side spin, Xu Xin moves so well. Takes it for low and spins it back for a winner. Think about how difficult this would be to even catch. Inside out here from Gozi. Xu Xin moves in just a bit, catches it while it's still high. Right off the bounce. Good timing here. Gozi brings himself within three. Still a ways to go, but the type of point that could really bring belief. Keep the hope alive here in game number four. Aggressive and as fast as can be, as soon as Gozi recognizes this ball is coming clear of the table. Gets the racket up.
Six, five.
Heavy spin on the backhand as well. No timeout on the Xu Xin side. She's just going for a little jog here. Again, the umpires have been very generous so far in terms of time for the players. Not warning players to play or asking them to come back to the table. A little bit more time without the ball kids as well.
Net, 6-5.
So 3 points in a row already for Gauzy. If he gets one more, he's tied it up. Second towel break just around the corner. Big backhand does it. Steps into the backhand side, finds the opening going to the forehand. Again, it's been risky to go to the forehand. The rare occasion that he does it, how low that is. That's below the net when he hits it and still drives it out of reach untouchably past Shushin. So second towel break and they're tied up now. Four in a row for Simon Gauzy. Timing again recoils quickly after Shushin counters. Simon Gauzy stays on top of the bounce. The streak continues. That last forehand. On several occasions now, how many times have we seen Simon Gauzy reaching out just with that racket up and still keeping the ball in play? The tomahawk chop block does not come back. Big point for Shushin to break the momentum after a long streak of points, five in a row from his opponent, Simon Gauzy. And the movement, that ball was wide when Shushin got there. Had he wanted to turn the corner the other way, it would have been very difficult. You can see how difficult it is to read when a player with so much feeling as Simon Gauzy has trouble controlling the side and topspin coming back. Ooh, almost. Would have been incredible. Soft, spinny shot to the short side, and Shushin with a bit of fortune off the edge. I've seen Gauzy play around the net shots two times in the same match on receive against Lee Song-soo. But off the edge of the table, it's pretty rare. Top edge of the racket for Gauzy, and Shushin now with a two-point lead. Right into the middle. Can understand the frustration after all that work to come back from down 2-6. Perfect shot from Shushin. The bare hand hits it back on the table. Had he been holding the racket in the left hand and it hit the palm or even the backside, anywhere between the wrist and the fingertips, that shot would count. But no question about it here, it was not the racket hand. Three game points for Shushin. Quick one off the bounce, forehand of Gauzy sends it to a third towel break. Two game points left for Shushin. Again, slightly limited resources compared to usual due to the state of the world right now. And Shushin takes it, 11-8, it's tied up.
Fifth game.
Back for game number five. And as you saw the close-up of the racket of Shushin, the forehand, the black side, the rubber cut a little bit lower to leave room for his pointer finger and his thumb, as many pen holders do. Just missing on the last shot. I want to see this from another camera angle, but Skylob's coming down at the baseline of the table. Shushin recovers the edge ball here. And then Gauzy plays, what, a chop with his forehand from under the table? I hope this replay lasts a while because there was a lot of excitement in this point. Here's the recovery. There's the shot, forehand scooper. It's a Shushin shot, and it almost comes down a second time. Wants to go around the net with that.
One, love.
Simon Gauzy a little bit disappointed to see the call made so late in the rally. Understandable. Point develops quite a bit. The backhand on the parallel. Taking advantage. Strong and confident Simon Gauzy ties it up. From the coach's corner, you saw Patrick Sheila a moment ago, Qin Zhijian there. Patrick Sheila trying to pump up Gauzy. perfect chop block. Soft and spinny, gets a passive ball back from the opponent. Typically, that's what chop blocks are meant to do. Although sometimes they come a bit longer and still even an attack has trouble lifting the ball. Oh, if he makes that shot, he pulls a Shushin on Shushin, that scooping shot. The show just continues to get more and more exciting. The quality of shot and the consistency goes. He turns sideways for that. Look at this. Oh, that's so much spin. Leaves the touch shot from Shushin, and then the parallel forehand just misses long. An aggressive forehand here, steady spin shot to the backhand. See Mongo Z up by one. Timing is good. Tough to control again with the ball bending a little bit in near the elbow. 3 points apiece at the first towel break. Dead even in points and games. The only time that Simone Gauzy won against Shushin, it was a 4-2 victory last year at the World Championships. Still a possibility here for the French showman. Got it. And the flick and surprise placement to follow. Good combination from Gauzy. So the flick just enough to start the rally. Top spin to the deep corner, but the backhand to follow, surprising Shushin. Just too strong, pins him in the backhand corner. Gets Simone Gauzy to rock up, play this with the forehand from deep. Clever play from the Cloudwalker. With that traditional penhold backhand, it looked like the push was going the other way. Very deceptive touch shot. Looked like there was more side spin on that ball to carry it back. Seemed like Simone Gauzy did the right thing to play it on the line. Again, Shushin's forehand is a beast. A clever long push here as well, a 2-point lead for Shushin. It's been quite a struggle for him so far. You don't hear Shushin vocalizing so much, although the second half of last year, and even this year, there has seemed to be a different intensity about him. Simone Gauzy gives just enough after the hooking shot comes back. Shushin gets everything back on the table and going for broke, just coming down on top of this last ball, a crushing kill shot. Gauzy moves back into the table. Inside out forehand, there it is. And jumping turns his whole body to make that shot. Spectacular play from Simone Gauzy. Back in front of the second towel break at Shushin. Now the winner here will be waiting for the winner of Liam Pitchford and Zhuang Zhiyuan. On the other side of the bracket, we've got Fan Zhendong waiting for the winner of Liang Jingquan and Wang Chuqin. So it will be an all-Chinese semifinal on the other side. On this side of the bracket, it'll either be 50-50, or if Simone Gauzy wins this match, there will be no Chinese players left on that side. Well played chop block here. Stays shallow and leaves Gauzy under the table, trying to lift and spin. It's a very tough position to be in. That backhand is deceptively strong and fast. Now you can see through the legs of Gozy when he's on the receive and throughout the points how strong he is physically. And he generates a lot of power from the legs on this backhand. Also his wrist clearly very strong and agile. Six serving eight. Ooh, top of the net and just out as it crawls along the top. Six serving nine. Gozy trying to keep the belief, the positivity. Doesn't miss by a lot, but loaded with spin. It's Shuxin who earns the point, has four game points to go up 3-2. The underside spin shot. Players back to the table. Game number six, Gozy to serve. Again, taking the pace off the ball. Smart play to leave it in front of Shuxin. So Simon Gozy down in games, but takes the first point here on his serve. Good early timing on top of the bounce. Both serves converted. Again, a soft, spinny one. Rarely do we see Shuxin on the ground for any reason. He manages to stay on his feet in the most impossible situations, or at least so it seems. See how low that ball is when he goes for it? Just takes a moment to rest there, really. Didn't fall. Oh, behind the back makes the contact. It's a bit of a home run with it, though. It is tough to control. Liam Pitchford, Daniel Habison, Mahadu Yoshimura, and Shuxin himself make it look quite easy. You might wonder why he does that. Well, when the ball's hit behind him, and he realizes he can't come across the front of his body to get the backhand in time, it buys him an extra moment. Just missing long, a lot of pressure to keep the ball deep in the lobs. That's the risk once you get behind the table against any player so strong in the attacking game. If it's a little bit shallow, they tend to be comfortable to hit a ball too wide to reach, too unpredictably. Good side spin there, though, from Shuxin. Oh, a break. Good cover of the middle. I thought Shuxin's recovery there for that second attack was so impressive. Quick backhand. Simon Gozy getting the upper body out of the way, plus the drop for two bounces. I think that was probably a moment later after the apology came, said, okay, stay strong. You've got this. Again, the level that is required to win four games against Shuxin. Just takes an incredible amount of focus. To win one game is tough enough. Quality opening backhand. Gozy continues. He's looking to take this to the decider. The spinny one on the parallel as well. Surprise, he could have gone anywhere with that backhand. Until the point of contact, it's tough to know where he's gonna go. If he snaps and straightens out the wrist, it goes to the far forehand corner, but here he leaves it behind.
Six, three.
Well played dealing with the side spin. Shuxin gains control of that point. Into the backhand corner once again. Zhuxin controlling from a step behind the table, keeping it uncomfortable for Gozy. So now six serving four. Or four serving six, rather. Big point here for Gozy, the difference between 6-5 and being up 7-4, especially considering the change of momentum. Zhuxin just watching that sort of charmed, stunned look on his face, or look on his face.
Seven, five.
A relatively empty underspin serve here. Second towel break, it's Gozy in the lead by two. Quick off the bounce, the inside out forehand. Gozy getting low to make sure he makes space to come inside this ball. Pendulum serve, commitment on the third ball. There's that bend. Serve drifting just a little bit long, and Zhuxin patiently there goes the other way. Doesn't go for the kill, just finds the placement, spins it deep. The angle there, when Zhuxin doesn't even try for it, that's a sign of something that is way beyond reach. No clouds leading the way on this one. Heavy spin comes in low. Gozy as wide as can be. Look at the bend on that ball. That's off the top of the table, too. No edge, and still it hooks that wide. 2-point lead now for Gozy. Ooh, counter backhand just long. I think that was the right decision to take it, though. Take his chances, make his way back in. The likelihood of lobbing down Zhuxin without an edge or a net ball to help you. Pretty rare, pretty unlikely. Nine serving eight. And now it is two game points for Simon Gozy to send this to the decider. I've heard many different quotes about game number seven. Some people say it's always 50-50 in game number seven. I think statistically that can't be true. But obviously, when you're playing a best of one game, it's a lot more unpredictable than a best of seven or a marathon. Just that short sprint. Gozy with the spinny one, changes the pace, and he sends it to the decider. So here we are, the decider, the final game of the match. Zhuxin, world number one with the serves.
Got it!
Some fierce determination to stay on the attack here. Again with a low ball coming in, gets aggressive. Qin Zhijian quickly on his feet. Again, if Simon Gozy wins this match, that means the final will be not China-China. Tries to get more aggressive with the backhand. Looked like Simon Gozy went down to the ground for a shot, and this comes back up and lobs. That was the moment right after. This last one just tries to put a bit more forward on it, make it a bit more aggressive to make his way back into the table. Heavy spin, Gozy with the racket speed and the very thin contact on that brushing ball. Loads it and leaves it uncomfortable for Zhuxin to counter.
Got it!
Relatively empty serve and a perfect read from Zhuxin. straight side spin on that anyway, as you could see in the replay. So the hands clapping in the crowd.
Three, two.
Little fortune here for Gozy. Changing up the pace for Shushin. Gozy within one. Shushin behind the table, still dangerous, but it'll definitely help out Gozy's chances. All right, down the line, Shushin turns. That's that wrist, that agile, fast wrist that we've seen throughout that Gozy has used so effectively in the receive game. Waits patiently to see where the opponent goes, and then at the last moment decides, I see him moving, I'm going the other way. Peripheral vision and patience. Threes all across. Despite the parallel forehand from Gozy, countered back, Shushin with a big recovery. That ball right there, on the run, Shushin still gets back and plays a forehand from the backhand corner. You could see just enough to know how important that last point was. When one player reaches 5 points, they will switch halves of the table. One player will have a bit of confidence, a bit of momentum. So the second serve not returned from Simon Gozy.
Net for all.
Oh, Strawberry comes out to play, and Shushin clips the net, but gets the point. Double apology to make sure Simon Gozy knows. Not so many players in the men's game doing the Strawberry, and Simon Gozy doing it better than almost any. I think probably has the best Strawberries in the men's game right now. Maybe period in terms of consistency. Miyu Kato incredible with that, Mima Ito as well. Five serving four.
Net, five, four.
Point, and Shushin stays stable as the counters come back into play. Gozy makes that forehand from the backhand side behind the table right there and then stays on the aggressive. A bit more confidence to do so from the forehand side, but another hooking, bending forehand from Shushin to secure the point. Scoreboard right now, four serving six. Good opportunity here for Gozy. Sees the line, has the opening. Again, has to be right near the line or Shushin will get his racket on it almost always unless he's turning the corner the other way. I was gonna say at the end of last game to come all this way for Simon Gozy, not take the win. A lot of work to play aggressively here. Simon Gozy follows up the break, stays on top of the bounce. The ball had almost dropped completely, and Shushin is catching the net post. Funny thing is, he could have gone around the net, and Shushin has been known to do that from time to time, but to really truly hit a roller, a ball that bounces twice on the table, or stays very low as it goes around the net. It's quite risky.
Four.
Well played. Heavy topspin from behind the table. Gozy shortens up the last ball. Fired up as can be, a big point right out of the timeout. Shushin back into the 2-point lead. I couldn't see the contact, but have to imagine there was more underspin on it. And Simone Gozy red. It's drying the racket there. It seemed that a drop of sweat maybe got onto the racket. Oh, and the inside out forehand again, the bend. Gozy within one. Get the bend on the ball. Talked about the side spin earlier. Usually when we're talking about side spin and Shushin's playing, it's because of Shushin. Played. Shushin down at the edge of the racket. Plays that one spinny and deep on the table. A very tough ball to counter. That stroke, there's the bend. And the side spin comes back. What Shushin invests pays off. The arcing spin shot just long. It is 3 game and match points for Shushin to move on to the semifinals. The last time I saw a 7-10 comeback against Shushin was the Olympic Games in 2016. Jun Mizutani down 7-10 in the fifth, the decider. Shushin from deep in the backhand corner.